Okay, whatever. That makes absolutely no sense. Okay? Hat is not a toy.
Bruh.
But a car. What's up, party people? Carolina Mike here, your host for SharePoint in 60 seconds, where you get the information you need in the first 60 seconds. And if you want more, stick around for a step-by-step walkthrough. Today, we're going to take the mystery out of the term store in SharePoint. That's right, we're going to talk about managed metadata. Let's rock and roll. Okay, before we get started, first and foremost, thank you for watching. Thank you for all who have followed. We are 1,598 strong, just two more for 1,600. So please like, subscribe, and hit that bell notification so you can know as soon as new stuff is available. So let's see if we can briefly explain managed metadata in the term store in 60 seconds or less. Timers, please. Okay, it's like this. It's a way for you to create a hierarchy of terms, manage it at an upper level, and then provide your users with some pretty neat choices in their metadata. For example, let's say you wanted to allow users to select the color blue, but then pick a shade of blue, or pick the color red and then the shade of red and have it all be in just one column. That's what you can do with the term store and manage metadata. Let's see it in action. First thing I suggest is create yourself a new demo site collection. I created a term store demo here. You can create whatever you like. Do whatever you like. My suggestion is keep it separate while you're testing this out. If you want to create yourself a regular team site that's not connected to a Microsoft 365 group or a Microsoft team, here's a link that shows you how to do that. Alrighty. So we're gonna take a look at a list we have here. We have a toys list, okay? And we wanna be able to, you know, have a column for color. You know, we want them to choose between blue and shades of blue, red and shades of red. So we're gonna take a step back and take a look at the site settings. So we gotta go site information, yeah, information.
Bruh.
Site settings, and we're gonna visit the term store under site admin. So this is gonna pop you into the term store. Now here, you can actually take a peek at the global terms. That's for all sites in the entire tenant. But we're gonna take a look at the site level, and we're gonna add a term group. And my understanding is that when you get a new site collection, there is no site level term group, and you have to create it. And this is one of the ways to do that. When you add this, you're gonna make it basically, you know, sort of assign it in name to the site collection. So this is a term store demo site. Okay, and there we go. And so I've got this folder. I don't see a way of creating another one. I believe that you just get one here, okay, for this site collection. So now we can start adding our term sets. So we know that one set of terms is going to be related to colors. And then within that color term set, we're going to add a term, and we'll go blue, and then we'll add another term. Oh, now if we're going to add a term to blue, it's going to be a shade of blue. So we'll add term, we'll go Carolina blue, and then we will go back up to blue and add another term, and we'll call that, let's just say navy. Boom. Okay. Shouldn't be that hard. Okay, so now we go back. So we want to add some choices for red. So we go back up to our set here, and we're going to add another term. We're going to go with red, and then we'll add a term within red. We'll go fuchsia. Check my spelling. Oh my gosh. Okay. And then we're going to add another term. We'll call it pink. So we can collapse these, and we can see what we got going on here. So, you know, this is basically the term store for the term store demo. It's a bit meta. And then we have colors that we're tracking. So we can add a colors column. And when folks access that column, they'll be able to see this hierarchy and select. Or they'll be able to just type in one of these terms and it will just pop in because it knows. It just knows. And if you needed to add another grouping, we'd add another term set, and I don't know, it would be, oh my gosh, I can't think of anything to type in here right now.
Bruh.
So we have groupings of colors. Why is sandpaper grit just... Okay, whatever. That makes absolutely no sense. Okay? just so you know. Anyway, now let's see how we can implement this column in the toys list. So we're just going to go back a few. We'll go to toys, and we want to add a column. Ooh, look, manage metadata. All right, let's pop in there. We're going to call it colors. Manage metadata, this term, set, or item. Wow, let's see, select. Oh, wow, we get to choose. All right, we're going to go, we don't need sandpaper grit. I'm just going to go here, and that should save it. Oh, this is super nice. Did that work? Colors, yep, let's save it. This used to be a few more clicks back in the day. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to add a new item, and we're going to go hat is not a toy.
Bruh.
And type term to tag. So we could say blue in colors was pink in red, Carolina blue in blue. So you could just do whatever you wanted to, or if you really wanted to go the manual route, you could say, okay, what are my choices? So we'll go blue, but maybe I want to pick a shade of blue, so let's go, it's more Carolina blue, and we'll apply, and we save it, and now we have Carolina blue. So there you go. That's your quick down and dirty method of implementing some managed metadata and giving your users some advanced choices in their drop-down menus. Again, please let us know what you think. Like, subscribe, and we will see you next time on SharePoint in 60 Seconds. Remember, do the best you can with what you got. SharePoint rocks, and so do you. And you, and you, and you. We'll see you next time.